Joy to the world, joy to the world of the Lord. giving him all the praises and honor. But I stopped by to tell you this morning that my master, is he your master? Our master. He is worthy to be praised. Heavenly Father, I ask that you send your Father, Son, and your Holy Spirit in here right now, Lord. Because we need your word. Lord, we need you now more than ever. We need to feel your joy and your love and your affection. And Father, we know as you go out to the highways and the byways and as you go on to the bridges and Lord, under the bridges where all the homeless people are, Lord, I'm asking that you give them joy, Lord. And Lord, as you grace your Father, Son, and your Holy Spirit in the hospitals, Lord, I'm asking that you grace them with joy. You see that joy in the morning and joy at night. But Father, we come just to continue to give you all the honor and the praises because we can't thank you enough. And Father, I ask that you look upon the man, Lord, who's going to bring the word, Lord. I'm asking that you send your Holy Spirit, Lord, so that he can bring us a joy, a joyous word, Lord. And Father, we ask in your name that you continue to bless each and every one of us, each and every person under the sound of my voice. And as you say, Father, do your best, be your best, and we allow you, God, to do the rest. In your name we pray, your joyful name.
Like a river in my soul.
his word saying, I am the Lord thy God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage, thou shalt have no other gods before me.
to celebrate this morning. Reflect on joy. Reflect on the word joy. And we as adults, we understand and know there's a difference between being happy and having joy. When you have joy, you know that anything that is impacting you, anything that is bothering you, will not overlook the fact that you have joy and become harmony in your soul. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We realize and we know that, and we want to reflect this morning. And those of you who are looking for it, all you have to do is talk to God. And Jesus, our Father, God our Father, who sent the Son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins, as we celebrate during this time, his birth, he gives us joy, he gives us peace, he gives us everything we need in order to do his will. So we want to celebrate and reflect on joy this morning. Joyful Lord, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubts away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day.
Yeah.
to our Minister of Music, Brother Craig Adams, the twins who are here doing their duties, Brother James and Brother Jerome. We thank you so much for your countless sacrifices throughout this pandemic, coming out week after week to make sure that our people can stay connected and does not go unnoticed. We applaud you. Turn with me, if you will, to the book of Psalms, Psalm number 146, and verses 9 through 10. Verses 5-10, a song that aligns to this season of Advent. It says, "The joyful are those who have the God of Israel as their helper, whose help is in the Lord their God. He made heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. He keeps every promise forever. He gives justice to the oppressed, food to the hungry. The Lord frees the prisoners. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are weighed down. The Lord loves the godly. The Lord protects the foreigners among us. He cares for the orphans and the widows, but he frustrates the plans of the wicked. The Lord will reign forever. He will be your God, our God, my God, O Jerusalem, throughout the generations. Praise the Lord." Just for a few moments, and I promise I won't be very long, I want to talk to you or speak on the question of thought, how can I have joy in the midst of a pandemic? How can I have joy in the midst of a pandemic? As we gather on the third Sunday of Advent, the Sunday of joy, during the season of waiting with anticipation for the birth of our Savior, one can easily find it hard to be joyful. When we are faced with the prolonged effects of this pandemic, people still getting sick and dying from this virus, with all the technological advances of this age, it's hard for us to be joyful. When we have young men and women of color being murdered all across the country, and their murderers are repeatedly being allowed to walk free, it's hard to be joyful. When our finances are dwindling and we can't get the help that we need, it's hard to be joyful. When we are watching our children struggle to adjust to the methods of learning that we've been forced to adopt, it's hard to be joyful. Yes, in this season of Advent, when we are trying our best to do what's pleasing in God's sight, but all hell is breaking loose in our lives, everywhere we turn, there is trouble in our homes, trouble on our jobs, trouble at our school, trouble in our community, trouble in our church, trouble in the choir, trouble on the usher board, trouble in the missionary society, Sons of Adam, steward board, trustee board, everywhere we turn, there is trouble. It's hard to be joyful. Amen. Yes, my brothers and sisters, it's hard to be joyful when we just left the doctor and have a bad report. Our bills are through and we don't have enough money to cover them. Our children are lost in a world of sin. How do we find joy in the midst of all of this stress? We constantly turn on the news and we see people by the thousands daily being infected with this virus. How can we be joyful? I submit to you that we need to look to Psalm 146. For in our text today, we are reminded that joyful are those whose hope is in the Lord, the God of Israel. Yes, we can find joy if our hope is in God. The problem is many of us today have placed our hope in the wrong things. Some of our hope is in our job. Some of our hope is in our spouse. Some of our hope is in our education. Some of our hope is in our government. Some of our hope is in finding a vaccine. Some of our hope is in our pastor. But I stop by here to tell you today that time is filled with swift transition,
law on earth on who can stand. We got to build our hopes on things that are eternal, and we must hold to God's unchanging things. Since so many of us find ourselves in the midst of a pandemic, finding it hard to be joyful, I want to share with you three reasons why we need to be blessed to find joy when we place our hope in God. And the first reason we can be blessed to find joy when we place our hope in God is because He is our Creator. Our text tells us that He made heaven and earth, sea, and all that is in them. Moreover, God created us. And who knows more about us than the one who created us? What are you trying to say, preacher? I'm trying to tell you that no matter what you're going through, if your hope is in God, you don't have to worry about it because He can handle it. He knows about every trial, every struggle, every mountain, every valley, every pothole. He knows about them all. And when we place our hope in Him, then He can safely navigate us through. I wish I had some help in the house today. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Is God ever navigated you through some tough times in your lives? Won't He make a way out of no way? Won't He open doors? Won't He be a bridge over troubled waters? I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that I serve a God that created me. He knows all about me, and when I'm in trouble, He can come and see about me. I'm going to find joy in my Creator. I'm a witness that in Him there is a unspeakable, unshakable, unattainable amount of joy. The type of joy that will make you shout and praise into the world if you want to be crying and losing your mind. Yes, there is joy. Creator, I told you I won't be before you long. I got one out of the way already. I got two more. Now the second reason that we can be blessed to find joy in the place I hope in God is because He is forever faithful. Oh yes. We got to have an unwavering faith in God while we are in the midst of our storm. Many of us can allow our minds to travel places that will place us in darkness. And that's a tool that the enemy will try to use to separate us from God. You know, we were kind of all right at first when everything started shutting down because we felt like, just a little while, maybe a week or two, at most a month. In my mind, I probably said, it was about March, I said, well, we'll probably be kind of limited until the end of the school year. But surely by the summer, things will begin to brighten. But you know, as long as you kind of have an idea of when this is about going to end, you know, you kind of deal with it and kind of mark in the days on the calendar and roll by. But as we find ourselves here now in month nine, it can allow some things to happen to you as we continue to see our friends and family members and church members become infected by the virus. Not only that, many of them to go on to be with the Lord. It can place our minds and our spirits in a dark place that will cause us to question our faith in God. But God is telling us today that we got to have an unwavering faith in Him. Moreover, no matter what comes our way, we got to stay the course. We got to carry out the mission. We got to stay on the battlefield. We got to keep our hands on the plow. Distractions may come, but we must remain faithful.
Oh, yes.
We've been through so much before. I think about our ancestors. They endured slavery, but they overcame. They endured Jim Crow, but they overcame. They still fought. They struggled. They educated themselves. They worked hard so that we wouldn't have to go through some of the things that they had to go through. They if they had given up? They were faithful. They maintained their faith, and we can't give up. Now, I don't know about you, church, but I've decided that whatever the test, whatever the storm, I know that God has planted me in it for a reason, so I'll keep on trusting Him. I'll be taking Him at His word. It's my faith that's going to bring me through. I'm just clinging on to the word of God that tells me that faith is the key that unlocks every door. That means that my faith will be the key that will bring me out of this pandemic. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Somebody saying, well, Pastor, what is faith? The Bible says that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. It tells me that faith, the size of a mustard seed, can move mountains. But I don't understand that, Pastor. I'm breaking right on down. It says, all faith means, although I may not see it with my eyes, I believe that God is going to fix it. I may have sickness in my body right now, but I believe that God can heal me. I don't know about you, church, but I'm learning how to walk by faith and not by sight. I believe that God can do the impossible. I believe that God can hear the coronavirus. I believe that God can speak life into my life situation. I believe that God can pay my bills when I don't have enough. I believe that God can heal my family. I believe that God can bring my church together. I believe that God can bring the stronghold that left me down. I may be in despair right now, but I know who holds the key to my deliverance. I know who to call on in a time of my struggle. I know where my strength comes from. And I know because I found out a long time ago when my back was against the wall. I lifted my hand up for heaven. I cried out, Father, and I stretched my hands for thee.
Raises up those who are bowed down, loves the righteous,
protects the lost and supports the orphan and the widow. Moreover, when I am in a weak position in my life, right now I'm weak, I'm bent down, I'm struggling right now, that's when God is in his best. Ah, my goodness. When I am weak, that's when God is at his best. In other words, when I am weak, that's when my God is strong. And in my Lord's part, that's when God is getting ready to show up and show out on my behalf. How many of you have ever had God step in for you? I'm a witness that he will take care of you. Yes, we can put our hope in God because he is our creator. We can put our hope in God because he is forever faithful. We can put our hope in God because he specializes in helping those who can't help themselves. So that my hope is in God. To worry about what's going on in the White House. But my hope is in God. I don't have to worry about what's going on under the police force. But my hope is in God. I don't have to worry about the violence in my community. But my hope is in God. I don't have to worry about what's going on with the vaccine. When my hope is in God, I don't have to worry about the trouble that's in my life. Why? Because we've already got it under control. There's no need for me to worry without having to pack over the course of history. And I can strike that there's never been a time in my life when God has let me down. He's always there. And they might be the response that I was looking for. But he was there. He was walking with me and talking with me every step of the way. I can echo the voice of Paul in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. We are sure of every side, yet not this strength. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not dismayed. For I'm a wrestler, full of power, with the stranger from the Lord. I don't know how you are. I don't know what you're going through. But there's nothing that's too hard for my God. He can fix whatever is broken in your life. It does not matter what you've done in the past. He's faithful and just to forgive you of your sin. Trust in him. Lean on him, depend on him, he will carry you through. I wish I had a witness in my house that had testified that God will, he will take care of you.
Thank you. I will trust. Thank you.
Praise God from whom all